I'm Dr. Sri, I'm a primary care sports medicine doctor practicing in the United States. In this video, I'm going to cover why cortisone injection is a cheap intervention for knee arthritis pain. I'm also going to discuss if the cortisone injection can make the arthritis worse or not. Okay, let's get started. So in patients with knee arthritis, we believe that the pain is coming due to the inflammation and the exposed bone without articular cartilage coverage. So what that means is that if I bring the inflammation down, the pain is most likely to get better. So there's a potential for pain relief by injecting steroids into the knee, which is an anti-inflammatory drug. So this is a cheap intervention that even a family medicine doctor can provide in the office. So usually I administer anywhere between 40 to 80 milligrams of triamcin alone, and I usually add some local anesthetics like lidocaine or bupivacaine. The steroid injections are relatively affordable. For example, in India, the cost is ₹75 to 100 per bottle, which is almost less than $1. Of course, this is just an estimate based on my Google search. Additionally, you'll have to pay a doctor's fee. However, overall, the cost of steroid injections can be quite reasonable. I believe that these injections are a great, cheap intervention that can really help my patients. However, I do have some reservations about offering them right away. Let me explain why. So there are multiple studies to show that the steroid injections can provide pain relief for almost 3 months. The question is that, does these injections come with risk? Again, there are procedural risks, such as, let us say if I do a steroid injection, there is increased risk of bleeding, there is increased risk of introducing infection. But the biggest question is that, does the steroid injection make the arthritis worse? Unfortunately, the answer is not straightforward. A study was conducted many years ago about the effects of steroid injections on knee arthritis. The results showed that there was no worsening of knee arthritis based on x-ray after 2 years. So this proved that, at least in the short term, the steroid injections did not make the arthritis worse. So now we have advanced technologies that can quantify cartilage loss. There was a recent study that was published that questions us whether we are doing harm by doing these corticosteroid injections, although I would say it's still not clear. So this paper was from JAMA in 2017. That compared around 70 adults in each group. So one group got corticosteroid and the other placebo. Interestingly and surprisingly, they did not find any pain difference, but they also did not find any significant clinical improvement of pain, which is not commonly seen with these types of injections. So the reason I say that these results are surprising is that most of the studies actually show pain improvement with these injections. The fact that they study did not find any pain improvement with both saline group and also cortisone injection group is surprising. In addition, they found that the patients who got the cortisone injection had an increased cartilage loss compared to the patients in the placebo group. Although there is research significance, that slight amount of cartilage loss, I cannot confidently say that this is going to push the patients to get the knee replacement surgery sooner. One other key point is that these patients were getting knee injections every 3 months, which is quite a lot. Are you finding value in this video? If yes, can you do me a small favor? Can you please hit the like and the notification button so that this video can reach more people? And if you have any questions, please post in the comment box below. So how do I advise my patients based on the studies that we have? So it is clear that the cortisone injection definitely has some slight risk. But let us say if you're going to use these injections very sparingly, like every 6 months to 1 year, then I think it's totally fine. It is still not entirely clear how effective other injections like hyaluronic acid or PRP when compared to cortisone, but they may provide similar relief. However, still cost is a factor to consider though. A recent New England Journal of Medicine study compared physical therapy and cortisone injection, and they found that at 1 year mark, people in the physical therapy group did far more better in terms of pain improvement compared to cortisone injection. Yes, physical therapy works. It may take time, but it's so much effective in the long run. So let us say you do everything right. For example, taking care of your diet, taking care of weight loss, and going to physical therapy regularly. In spite of that, there's an ongoing pain, then here and there, cortisone injection should be totally fine.